What we want to see and what we're looking to see is, what is the cognitive impact of CrossFit on people? Does it help them focus better? Does it help them think more clearly? Does it actually improve the function of their brain? And what better people to work with than teachers?
It really begs the question, what would happen if we take these 18 teachers, administrators, and put them into a box and let them experience it?
I really want to expose them to as many different workouts as I can. I want them to think about, what can I do with my class?
Can we turn on that light, like, yeah, that might be important to teach our students?
Oh, absolutely. I think it should be, you know, a beacon of light.
You can't force this team building or these bonding exercises, but you put them through CrossFit and it's amazing how close these people are going to get to each other.
Teachers need to take control of their health and fitness so they can be better role models for their students. This is our audience. This is who we're in front of for 8 hours a day.
They're going to see their lives changed.
If they don't have mobility for overhead squats, it'll be front squats. Since we're not doing pull-ups, they're going to be doing burpees. If you're not able to get a full overhead squat, you're going to instead hold the bar in that front rack position and do front squats instead of the overhead squats. We're going to run it in heat since we only have 3 bars. 3, 2, 1, work.
And I think we talked about it on day one with these administrators, that they're the ones that lead from the front. They're the ones that these kids see and try and emulate from early on. So now, you know, when they talk about, hey, well, I just did this, or I just did that, or I'm eating healthy, or I'm going to get my workout after school, I gotta get out of here. These kids see this, and these kids are gonna now pick up on, okay, well, wow, my teacher is talking about eating healthy, and she's going to work out after school.
I've noticed that their morale overall has improved. Just like being at school, their attitude's better and they're more personable than I have noticed at other years. I mean, that might just be me, but I kind of noticed that.
Teachers need to understand that they are the first real impact that our kids have, you know, outside of our parents, outside of mom and dad. The teacher is that next person that spends more time with our kids than we do as parents. So I think it's important for them to be, you know, doing the right things and leading from the front.
We get in it for the kids, and they have to come first. So the fact that even these teachers made the time for themselves through this whole process is huge, and it is a success that so many stuck with it.
What I think has been really cool is you see the 6 or 8 people that have really taken it seriously and spent the 4 months here, and they see drastic changes. I mean, amazing differences, and it's not so much their what they look like or how their clothes fit, it's how they feel. I think that's what we told them on day one is, I don't care what the scale says, I care about if they feel better. Do they feel, is their quality of life day in and day out better now than it was 4 months ago? And I think the answer to that question from all of these 6 or 8 people is absolutely.
It's been awesome. I continue to say, I don't think I ever would have walked off the street and had the courage, the fortitude to do this on my own. But with my group, oh man, it was good. It was good. It wasn't easy, but it was good.
This is the closest thing to developing and maximizing your fitness potential that's out there. I care about is getting us strong from here to here. Everything else will take care of itself. If I can get us strong from here to here, it's a win.
All right.
The point of this is not to haze you guys and make you never want to do CrossFit again. So the first couple weeks, it's fine if we're really sore. If we just work the fundamental movements and we don't do a workout, I'm fine with it. We're still gonna be way better off than if we don't do this at all.
It's been amazing. It really has. I've tried a lot of things over the years, and this one really worked. I can tolerate things that I couldn't tolerate before, so I know I'm stronger, I'm healthier, I'm leaner. And you know, the other thing that is so great about this whole process, though, is that I have confidence in myself in ways that I never thought of. I never imagined that this whole process would create. I'm 59 years old. I never thought that I could lift the weight that I'm lifting or do the kinds of things that I'm doing. And I know that I can do that and more. And I just don't want to stop.
Your goal was very personal when you started this.
Yeah, I'd had a real wake-up call about my health.
I got some bad news a couple months ago, and they diagnosed me with breast cancer. And so I have gone through the surgery, and I'm in radiation right now.
And I was getting concerned, and I want to be here. You know, I don't, and I want to be active, and I want to explore things and travel and do and bike and run and hike and, you know, just be a part of this world that I'm in.
You're one of our girls who were not able to continue, and for good reason.
That's right.
But you're here to celebrate the final day with us.
Tell us
what's the big news?
The big news. So I did my first 2 months of CrossFit being pregnant, didn't know, and then found out that we were pregnant with twins. So had to take it easy, but I look forward to getting back to it.
My main motivation for joining was really just like getting to know people. Like I was new to Canon this year, so I'd only been there like 2 months until when I got that first email from Meredith. And for me, it was like a way to like, okay, great, I can like meet people. Like my husband's a college coach, so he's out of town a lot. We don't have any kids, so it's like kind of hard to meet people. And I figured this is gonna be a great way for me to like get to know coworkers. And it was awesome like doing the open with some of them, and like we went out for food after, and like we go into each other's rooms now, and like we can talk to each other. So for me, like I guess the workout was a bonus. Like I was really just, you know, doing it to have that social connection.
And out of nowhere there was Nia's voice, and she was far away, and she just came and she was like, I see you, keep going, you can do it. And I was just like,
you probably didn't even realize that was like the first time she ran without stopping. So the fact that you motivated her, that was a big deal for her.
Yeah, I didn't know that until after. So it's awesome to hear that she'd run like a mile and a half. And I didn't even know she didn't think she'd be able to run again.
We just wanted to give this to you, Steve, to say thank you for everything
that you did for us and all your patience and hard work with this difficult group.
Well, my daughter, Reagan, thanks you for the patience that I've gained from this. I can promise you that. And,
we altered the cards just a little bit.
For testing my resolve, for prolonging my agony, sustaining my misery, continuing my torture, and for enduring my complaints. That's awesome.
This is a gift for you from all of us as a small token of our thanks for all your hard work to put this together for us and convince us to walk through the door.
Where do we go from here? If we can't get CrossFit in the schools across the board, at least now we see what it can do for a staff and a faculty to bond as a group and to then have their lives changed for the better, so that when they're in school, they're acting as the positive role model for the students.
I would love to know that all schools have some sort of CrossFit-based PE programs, but if they don't do it, I want to do it for them. I want to help these kids because they can do it.